Hey everyone, in this lesson you will learn how to create brick wall textures for 3D renders. This tutorial is a follow-up to another video on how to create the seamless texture that you see here. If you haven't seen it already, then click on this link. So, continuing from previous lesson, I'll select all layers and group them by clicking Ctrl-G. Rename it to Diffuse. Duplicate the group and merge it down. To make the bricks bulge out from the wall when rendering, we need to create a displacement map. For that, the gaps should be darker and the bricks brighter, so they will pop out from the surface. We could try to go the easy way by inverting the image, removing the colors, and increasing the contrasts. But this result would not work that well when rendering. A better way to go is by creating a selection of the gaps area and separating it from the bricks, like in this following example. Let's start with a rough selection. Click on Color Range under Select tab. Pick the color you wish to make a selection for. Change the preview to Quick Mask to see it on the texture. You can add more colors to the selection by holding down Shift. Be careful not to add too many colors. You can control the mask amount by changing the fuzziness slider. The gap selection looks pretty clean, so we can click OK and move on to refining the selection. Click on Refine Edge and switch to Overlay mode. The smooth slider helps to smooth the edges and eliminate small selection dots. The feather helps to blur hard edges. Set it to a low value of about 2. The shift edge offsets the edges inwards or outwards. Shift it a bit outward so it will cover the brick's edges. Duplicate the layer and add the layer mask to the new layer. Now we have isolated the gaps from the bricks. Let's invert the selection by selecting the layer mask and clicking Ctrl-I. Create a background by adding a new layer and filling it with black color. The mask that we've created needs a little manual fixing. Select it and paint with a white or gray color on bricks that need fixing. Add a hue saturation layer and reduce the saturation all the way to remove the colors. Double click on the bricks layer to open the layer style window. Enable color overlay and set it to white. Reduce the opacity to about 60% so details on the bricks could show through. Do the same for the background layer, make sure that the original texture is under. Go over the whole image to see if it needs some more fixing. Save the texture as a JPEG or PNG. Next, I'll create a bump texture that will emphasize the smaller details of the surface. In the example on the right, you can see the effect of the bump map along with the displacement map. Select these three layers and group them. Rename the group Displace. Duplicate it and rename the new group as Bump. Bring up the details by reducing the opacity of the color overlay effect. Reduce the background opacity as well. Save it as BAMP. Finally, let's create a reflection texture. These type of bricks have very little reflection in the real world, almost non-visible. So for that I'm just going to darken the image with levels and use saturation. Save it as reflection texture.